First of all, I didn't take last 3 weeks. I was unable to take the classes as I was out of the island. I'm really sorry for that. In my last class, I started short-term decision making, and in short-term decision making, I discussed what is relevant cost and the characteristics of relevant cost, then the examples for relevant costs, then also what are the costs that are not relevant, all these I discussed. Then there were some decisions. So one, we did a question on how to decide on the minimum price quotation for special orders, taking the relevant cost principles, how to calculate that. And then also I discussed the question on when there is a limiting factor, how to make decisions. Then to continue with that today, I'll take a question where you can see there are so many limitations, but only one factor is a limiting factor. One of the limitations is a limiting factor. Okay, remember, you should know the difference between limitations and a limiting factor. A limitation is where the resource, a particular resource, is limited in supply. So when there is a limitation, that does not mean that the limitation should be a limiting factor. A limitation will become a limiting factor only if the quantity available is not enough for the production. For example, let's say labor hours available is not sufficient to produce 100% capacity. So then in that case, that will become a limiting factor. So if you consider this question, there are so many limitations. There are two products. For each product, there are limitations. And you can see for each product, only one limitation becomes a limiting factor. Okay. Let us consider that question. This question number 3 on page 7. Turn to page 7. Question number 3. AB Limited is an established supplier of precision parts to a major aircraft manufacturer. It has been offered the choice of making either part A or part B for the next period, but not both. So a company has been requested to produce one of the two products, either part A or part B, but not both. So the company has to decide which is better. Both parts use the same metal, a titanium alloy, of which 13,000 kilos only available, so which is a limitation. That is the common material for the two parts is that titanium alloy, which is only a limited quantity is available for the period. So 13,000 kg, so it's a limitation. At 1250 per kg, the cost price of the material is 1250. The parts are made by passing each one through the two fully automatic computer-controlled machine lines, S&T, whose capacities are limited. So these parts are produced using computerized controlled machines. So that means no manual labor involved, all computerized, and they are produced by two machines, machine S and machine T. No labor is involved. Target prices have been set, and these machine times are also limited in supply. So there are two more limitations: machine time available and also machine time S and T available per period. They are limited in supply. Target prices have been set, and the following data are available for the period. So look at the schedule. Target price, the maximum call-off in units. What do you mean by call-off? Is the demand. The other term for demand is call-off. So maximum call-off, maximum demand for the two products. Part A, 7,000 units, and Part B, 9,000 units. Target prices, this is a CIMA question, so in sterling pound, £145 per Part A and £115 per Part B. Alloy usage, that is the material that is used in production, that alloy material, it's 1.6 kg per unit for Part A, and Part B also 1.6 kg. Then machine times available, machine times required for these two products, that is 5 hours per unit of Part A, machine S, 0.6 hours per unit, and Part B, 0.25 hours per unit. Similarly, machine T, hours per unit, 0.5 hours per Part A, and 0.55 hours per Part B. Then the machine details, the time available, machine hours available, like machine S, 4,000 hours, machine T, 4,500 hours. Variable overhead per machine hour, that is to run machine S for 1 hour, it costs the company, that is the variable production cost, £80. To run the machine T for 1 hour, it costs £100. Explain which part should be made during the next period to maximize contribution. So you have been asked to choose the best product, either Part A or Part B. Calculate the contribution which AB Limited will earn and whether the company will be able to make the maximum call off. So that is whether they can utilize the entire demand. As an alternative to the target prices shown above, the aircraft manufacturer has offered the following alternative arrangements. So that is target price. So there is some arrangement that is the customer is suggesting something. That is, instead of charging the target prices, that is £145 and £115, they want the company to give 10% discount on the target price and charge £60 per hour for each of the unused machine hour T and machine hour S, unused hours, to charge £60. So now we'll have to check for Part B. We have to check whether Part C. We have to check whether the original arrangement or this customer's requirement, the customer's request, whether which one is cheaper. So which one is better for the company? We'll have to decide on that. Discuss whether your recommendation in Part A above will be altered, and if so, calculate the new contribution. Okay. So now we'll consider the limitations. So how many limitations are there? One, the maximum demand. So the company can't produce, if they want to produce Part A, they can't produce more than 7,000 units. Similarly, if it is Part B, cannot be produced more than 9,000 units. So that is limitation one. Then limitation two, the number of units possible with machine S time, and also the number of units possible with machine T time. Then also we have to consider the number of units possible, material available, material, alloy material available. So there are four limitations for each product. But remember, out of the four, only one will be the limiting factor. So for each product, We'll have to see what is the limiting factor. We have to decide on that one. Then the quantity will be decided based on the limiting factor. So now we'll consider how many machine hours, machine S time possible with the, that how many units are possible with machine S time available. Look at that machine S time available, 4,000 hours. So 4,000 divided by each unit of part A requires 0.6. So divided by 0.6, it will be 6,667, 66 units. You have to round it. So 4,000 hours are available. Each unit requires 0.6. So it will be 6,666 units. Don't round it up, okay? Because the number of units for 67, it will require more than 4,000 hours. But the hours, number of hours available, it's only 4,000. So you have to round it down, okay? Similarly, machine T time available, 4,500. 4,500 divided by 4,500 divided by each unit of part A requires, it's 0.5 hours. Part A, 0.5. Look at the schedule, 0.5. So that means with that 4,500 hours of machine T time available, it can produce 9,000 units. It can produce 9,000 units. With that machine time S available, it can process only 6,666 units. Remember, maximum demand 7,000. Now look at the alloy material. Alloy material available, 13,000 kg, and each unit of part A requires 1.6. So material available 13,000 kg, each unit will require 1.6 kg. So 13,000 divided by 13,000 divided by 1.6, it will be 8,125 units. So if you consider part A, in case if the company wants to produce part A, the maximum demand 7,000. So in any case, the production should not exceed 7,000. But 7,000 units are not possible if you consider the machine time S available. With the machine time S available, only 6,666 units are possible. This is 9,000 is all right, 8,105. So among the four limitations, the limiting factor for part A would be its machine time S. So this will become the limiting factor. This will be the limiting factor for part A. The company wants to produce part A, the limiting factor would be only one limiting factor. There are so many limitations. There are four limitations. Among the four, this becomes the limiting factor for part A. Similarly, part B, if we consider part B, the time, machine time available 4,000. And each unit will require 4,000 divided by 4,000 divided by its each unit of part B requires 0.25 hours. So 16,000 units are possible with the machine time S available. The company can produce 16,000 units. maximum demand 9,000. So among the two, if you take these two, with these two we can say it should go beyond 9,000 because the maximum demand. But whether that is possible, we'll have to see the other two also. Then machine tea time, it requires 4,500 hours of machine tea time available, and each unit will require machine tea time 0.55 hours. So divided by 0.55. So the number of units, 4,500 divided by 0.55. It will be 8,181. Don't round it again, don't round it up, round it down. 8181 units. So with the machine tea time available, this is the number of units that is possible. Okay. Then there is one more limitations. The material available, there are 15,000 kilograms of material available for the period. Each unit requires 1.6. So it will be same as this, 8,120. Now if we consider the four limitations, in this case the limiting factor would be the smallest quantity, because after 8,125 units, no more material to produce further units. So after 8,125 units, no further units would be possible without this material. Material will be fully utilized at that point. So this will become the limiting factor. Material will become the limiting factor for part B. For part B, the material will be the limiting factor. So now the production is decided based on the limiting factor. So in this case, the production would be, if you consider the production, if the company considers part A, the maximum number of units that is possible, 6,666 units. If they want to produce part B, 8,125 units. So now the company has to decide which is better, producing 6,666 units of part A or producing 8,125 units of part B. Which is better in terms of the financial aspect? Which is better? So let us consider the profit. We'll calculate the profit or the contribution in each case. Work out the contribution. Whether 6,660 units of part A gives more contribution than 8,125 units of part B. So the next calculation will be these two. That there are two options. So let's say option one is producing 6,666 units of part A. Similarly, option two is producing 8,125 units of part B. Which is better? We have to consider these two. Which gives more contribution? That should be calculated. So for which, to calculate the contribution, they have given the selling price, everything. so we can work out the contribution. So we'll work out the contribution. So revenue, we have to work out the revenue, and we'll say revenue less this variable cost, material, no labor here, all fully computerized process. So therefore it will be the variable production cost, variable production cost and there we can divide that as machine S and machine T time. Machine theta. That's it. Material. Revenue. Look at the revenue. Revenue, the selling price is target price £145. So revenue £145 into 6,666. So it will be the next short-term decision making is that make or buy decisions. Make or buy decision is in certain cases the company has to decide on, say for example, if a company produces a product using say 5 or 6 components. A product is made using 4 components. And if the company wants to, let's say, increase the production, but there is a limiting factor. So when there is a limiting factor, then the production cannot be increased. For example, it could be either material, labor, or any other resource is limited in supply and also not sufficient to produce any more units. So when there is a limiting factor, if they want to increase the production, they can. If the product is assembled using 3 or 4 components, we'll assume a particular product is assembled using say 3, 4 components. 5 components, let's say A, B, C, D, and E. So using 5 components, a product is produced using this 5 components assembled and obtained that product. So in this case, say if they want to increase, we'll assume the limiting factor is labor. Or the limiting factor is machine time, anything. We'll assume the limiting factor is labor. So if the limiting factor is labor, then if they want to produce all 5 components internally, we'll assume that each one, say for example, product A, we'll assume the labor hours available, say 5,000 hours per period. And we'll assume each unit of A requires 10 hours of labor. Each unit of B, 3 hours of labor. C, 2 units, 2 hours of labor. E, we'll say 4 hours of labor. D, 1 hour of labor. So that means they want to, if they want to produce that product, they need 20 hours of labor. 10, 13, 15, 16, 20 hours of labor. So to produce 1 unit of this product, they need 20 hours of labor. If we assume the total labor is available, total labor available is 5,000 hours, it is possible to produce only 250 units. 5,000 divided by 20. So only 250 units per period is possible. Now if they want to increase this, if they want to increase that output with the labor is available, it may not be possible. But in this case, if they can obtain one of these parts from outside, one or more than one part from outside, then they can increase the production. So that if, for example, if they can buy part E from outside, for every unit, they can save 4 hours. So in that case, it will be only 16. So they need only 16 hours to produce the rest if they want to buy only part E from outside. Or let's say they want to produce, say, 3 parts, B, E, D, from outside. Then they need 12 hours only. So in that case, they can increase the production. So by obtaining some of these components from outside, they can increase the production. And whether that is worthwhile or not, we'll have to check. So that is the short term, one of the short term decision making situations. So there is a question here where you have to make a decision whether to produce internally everything and sell, or buy some of the components from outside. If we want to buy one of the components from outside, which one to buy from outside is better, okay, more profitable. So that is the type of decision you make, one of the short-term decision-making situations. So if you look at that, the note given here, make or buy decisions, businesses may face with the decision whether to make components for their own products themselves, or to concentrate their resources on assembling the products, obtaining all the components or some of the components from outside suppliers instead of making themselves in-house. So which is better, they have to make a decision. If the components are bought outside, there will be a problem. That is, we'll have to check on this one. Say, this product, you are going to assemble all these components and you sell this product as one unit. And remember, if one of the products that you buy from outside fails before the others, then the entire unit will be waste. So then the customer, now if the quality of the suppliers, if the quality of the subcontractor's product is not up to the mark, then the company will lose the image, because the people will talk about the company's product. They will say that, this company's product is not good. They don't know that particular part has been obtained from outside. So they will think that the company's product is not up to the standard. So there is a risk of, that if the subcontractor's parts are not up to the standard, the company will lose its image. That risk would be there. Okay. If the components are bought out, their purchase cost is wholly variable. On the other hand, if it is produced internally, the comparative cost of doing so will be the direct cost, direct material, labor, and variable overhead. So if the variable production cost of components when it is manufactured internally is higher than obtaining similar components elsewhere, then it is obviously uneconomic to produce them internally. So where that you have to make a decision. We'll check on this. There's a question given. This was given in one of the SEMA papers, exercise 1, on make or buy decisions, where a product, okay, that is Easy Care Limited, produces 4 components, P, Q, R, and S, for which cost in the forthcoming year would be as follows. So it's given here, that is a component P, reduction in units, 1,000 units. Component Q, 2,000 units. Component R, 3,000 units. And S, 4,000 units. Direct material cost, that is in rupees per unit. Direct material, 800. Labor, 1,600. Variable production overhead, 400. So in total, 2,800. Similarly, product Q, that is component Q, 2,000 units produced. The direct material, they need 2,000 units. Direct material, 1,000 rupees. Direct labor, 1,800. Variable production overhead, 600. So total variable cost, 3,400. Similarly, product R, 800, 1,200, 400, in total 2,400. Product S, 400, 800, and 200, it will be 1,400. Then there are specific fixed costs that is pertaining to each of these components, P, Q, and R, P, Q, R, and S. For P, 200,000 rupees, that specific fixed cost. Q, 1 million. R, 1,600,000. These are in thousands. General fixed overheads, 600,000. Subcontractor has offered supply, the components P at 2,400 rupees, Q 4,200 rupees, R 2,800 rupees, S 2,000 rupees. Discuss whether EasyCare Limited should make or buy the components. So this PQ and PQR and S, whether they should produce internally or buy from outside. If they want to buy from outside, what are the units that they have to buy from outside? So look at this, the components. So components, P, Q, R, and S. P, Q, R, and S. In this case, we'll have to compare the purchase cost. That is, if that component was bought from outside, what would be the purchase cost? So, and then the internal cost of production. So, cost of production, variable cost of production. Variable cost of production. That should be compared with the purchase cost. Purchase cost, if it was purchased outside. Purchase cost, if the component was bought from outside. If the component was bought from outside. Was bought from outside. If you consider product P, it's the total variable cost 2,800. Variable cost 2,800. Q, 3,400. R, 2,400. And S, 1,400. If it was purchased, if the component was purchased from outside, a subcontractor has offered for the supply of components like this. Product P, 2,400. So in this case, if the company buys from outside, they will gain 400 rupees. Bought from outside, they will gain 400. If they produce internally, they lose 400. So we'll consider one of these two, either produce internally or buy from outside. Let's say produce internally. Produce internally. Then what will happen? if they produce internally, they lose 400 rupees because it could be obtained. We'll assume that there is no difference between the quality of the subcontractor's product and the company product. If we assume that, there are other factors, but we will assume the other factors remain the same. So in that case, the company will lose 400 rupees. So there the cost of production. So 400, the company loses 400. Then look at Q, 3,400 production cost, and outside supplier charges 4,200. So in this case, 800 rupees positive contribution 800, that is the company can save. So the saving is positive, and saving or increase in cost. In this case, increase in cost. If they produce internally, it will be an increase in cost. In this case, it will be a saving. If they produce internally, there will be a saving of 800 rupees. Similarly, product are 2,400. But if they want to buy from outside, it will be 2,800. 2,800. So in this case, 2,400, that is production cost. So this is 2,000. They lose, so the 2,800 outside cost more. Sorry, this is the. It's the other way around. It's production cost, no saving, increase in cost. In this case, saving. In this case, saving. Saving 400. 400 saving. 2,800 outside. But the company, if it produces internally, they can save 400. Then product D, it's 1,400 production cost, that is outside supplier. The subcontractor will charge 2,000 rupees. So again, it will be saving of the 2,000. So it's 2,600 rupees saving. But remember, now in this case, immediately you can make a decision that product P should be bought from outside. So in this case, you are losing. There is no saving. Your cost will increase. If you produce internally, your cost is going to increase. So therefore, should be bought from outside. Should be bought from outside. So that is that immediately you make that decision. Product component P should be bought from outside. Now if you take the other three components, we can't say all three should be produced internally because there are specific fixed costs also involved. So therefore, we have to see whether now this, you take leave P among Q, R and S, we have to see whether it's worthwhile producing internally, taking that specific fixed cost into account. So if you work out that one, the saving, the total saving, from that one, we'll have to subtract the specific fixed costs. So the next one, you consider the rest of the components, Q, R, and death, what would be the total saving? So we'll work out the total saving. Total saving for product Q, every unit that is produced internally, the company can save 800 rupees. And how many units to be produced? 2000 units. So total saving 800 into 2000. So that will be 1,600,000. 5 zeros. 1,600,000. Similarly, component R on each unit produced, the company can save 400 rupees. And total number of units, 3,000. So 400 into 3,000. Again, 12 and 5 zeros, 1,200,000. Total saving. Then 600 into component R, component S, production is 4,000 units. So 24 and 5 zeros, 2.4 million. So this is the total saving for each of these components. And there are specific fixed costs with each of these components. Leave P, okay? And also leave general fixed costs. Whether the company produces these components or not, they are going to incur that general fixed cost. So that also we are not worried about that. So we'll take Q, R and S. Q, it'll be 1 million. Specific fixed cost. Specific fixed cost. Specific fixed cost. 1 million. So net saving, that is say gain or loss, we'll give the loss within brackets. So in this case, gain, if it is produced internally, you gain 600,000 rupees. Product R, 1,600,000. Specific fixed cost. So therefore, you lose 400,000. So remember, you may think here it's the purchase price the purchase price is the variable cost of production is 2,400, purchase price is 2,800. So therefore, producing internally is cheaper. But then, since we consider this specific fixed cost is given for each of these components, we have to see that saving what you get from that one should not exceed the specific. If it exceeds the specific fixed cost, is fine. But if you can't cover the specific fixed cost, it's not worth. That is that it happens here. Okay. In this case, specific fixed cost, 1,200,000. So therefore, the gain would be 1,200,000. So in this case, again, buy from outside. R also should be bought from outside. Should be bought. Should be bought from outside. Should be bought from outside. So in this case, only two products, only two components that should be produced internally, which are Q and R. P and R, Q and S. P and R should be bought from outside. So initially, you compare the purchase price. If it was bought from outside, what would be the purchase price? Compare that with variable cost of production. if the variable cost of production is smaller than the amount here, the purchase price, then you should produce internally. If this is more than the purchase price from outside, then you should buy from outside. So that is no problem. But sometimes it may be cheaper to produce internally, but when you consider the specific fixed cost, whatever saving you get on that one may not be sufficient to cover the specific fixed cost. That happens in this case. Then it should be bought from outside. That also should be bought from outside. So you have to consider this. This is a make or buy decision problem without any limiting factor. Okay. There is no limiting factor here. Okay. So without any limiting factor, a make or buy decision where no limiting factor. Now we have to consider make or buy decision with a limiting factor. Okay. With a limiting factor. So in that case, how that will be. Okay. So the next question given is a make or buy decision where you have to consider which component should be bought from outside when there is a limitation. It's 145 pounds and quantity 6,666. So 666 into 145. It will be 9,665,966,000. Requires 1.6 kg. So that means it's per unit. Per unit, it will be 1250 into 1.6. It will be 20 pounds. 1250 into 1.6, 20 into it's 6,666. So it will be 133,000. 133,320. Material, each unit requires 1.6 kg into per kg the price 1250. So that means for each unit of part A, it will require 20 pounds worth of material. So that into 6,666 units. So that is negative. All these we have to subtract from that one. So it's a production, that is material. Then machine S time, each unit requires 0.6 hours. Material machine time S, 0.6 hours. So 0.6 into 6,666 units. So that means total time required 3,999 hours, 0.6 hours. That into the rate is 80 pounds per hour. So it will be 319,968. Then machine T time, each hour costs 100 pounds. How many hours are required? Each unit of part A requires 0.5 hours. So 0.5 into 6,666 units, which will require 3,000. That is 3,333 hours. that into 100 will be 333,000. 300. That's it. So now the total, no labor, it's only material and variable production costs. So that is the total of the three, material 133,320 plus machine S time 319,968 and machine T time 333,300. So total will be 700 less 786,588. And the contribution would be 966, 570 minus, so that is 179,982. The option one will give a contribution of 179,982. It's 966,570 minus 786,588. It's 179,982. Similarly, option two. Option two is where company can make 8,125 units. So producing 8,125 units of part B. In this case, revenue would be, what is the target price of part B? 115 pounds. Into 8,125 units. So let's say sterling pounds. 115 into 8,125. It will be 934,000. Similarly, variable costs, less, we'll say variable costs. Variable costs, you have to consider the material and variable production cost. Material, it's 1250 per kg, and each unit requires 1.6 kg. So that means 20 pounds per unit. How many units are possible? 8,125 units. So it's 1250 into 1.6 into 8,125. 162,500. Then variable production costs. One is machine S time. Machine S time. Each unit requires 0.25 hours. Look at under part B, machine S time, 0.25 hours. And how many units? 8,125. The rate for machine S time, the rate is 80 pounds. So 80 into 0.25 into into, so that is 20 into 8125, which will be 162,500. Then machine T, machine T time costs 100 pounds per hour, and how many hours are needed? Each unit requires 0.55 hours. So 0.55, and how many units? 8125 units. So it will be 100 into 0.55 into 8125, which will be 446,875. No other variable costs, no labor, because these are fully computerized production lines. So in this case, the total variable cost would be 162,500, again 162,500, so 162,500, again 162,500, 446,875. So total variable cost would be 771,875. And therefore the contribution would be its revenue 934,375 minus 771,875, 162,500, again 934,375 minus 771,875 gives you 162,500. So there are two options. The company can either produce 6,660 units of part A, that is the maximum quantity that is possible, because here that machine S time is the limiting factor. So that decides the quantity, and that gives the contribution of 179,982. Then the second option is, if they want to produce part B, this will become the limiting factor. So among the four, they are the smallest quantity that will decide the production. So production 8,125 units, and that gives a contribution of 162,500. So among the two, this is the highest contribution. Higher contribution, and therefore the company should produce, company should supply part A, and it can supply 6,666 units of part A. So comment. The company should supply part A in order to maximize contributions. In order to maximize contributions, and how many units are possible? 6,666 units. And in that case, machine S time would be the limiting factor. So it's answer to part A. Explain which part should be made. That is part A. During the next period, to maximize contribution. So to maximize contribution, it should be part A should be produced. Now calculate the contribution which AB Limited will earn. So that is 179,982. This is the contribution that they can earn. And whether the company will be able to meet the maximum call-off. In this case, not possible to meet the maximum call-off because the number of units, we are now select part A. We select part A and in this case, the limiting factor is machine S time. So with the limiting factor, only this quantity is possible. And this is well below the maximum demand. So the company is unable to meet the maximum demand or maximum call off. So here in the comment or part B, we can say, it is not possible. It is not possible to meet the maximum call-off, the maximum call-off, or you can say demand for the maximum demand for product A of 7,000 units as machine S time is not sufficient to produce it. So that is answer to part B, why it's not possible to meet the maximum demand here, because there is a limiting factor. So machine S time is not sufficient to meet that demand, maximum demand. Now part C. So part C, that is where the customer is giving some suggestion. So customer is giving a suggestion whether the company can give them 10% discount on the target price, whether they can give 10% discount on the target price and charge £60 for the unused machine time. So we'll have to see whether that is worthwhile. Okay. So we'll have to see for each product. We'll have to check on that one. So maybe in this case, whether part B is more profitable, we don't know. So we'll have to check on both products. So this time we'll give the working, taking the customer's suggestion into account. So this is that the customer's suggestion to give 10% discount on part C with the aircraft manufacturer's suggestion, or you can say customer's suggestion, with the customer's suggestion, which is better suggestion. Now that in this case, the company will lose on that discount payable, discount allowed, and will gain on unused machine time. So we can compare without doing the whole thing. We can compare these two. Say one, discount allowed. So for each part, let's say part A and part B. You have to compare these two. Part B. One is a discount allowed. Discount allowed. It's 10%. So they are losing 10%. Remember, 10% of this is 96,000. You divide it by 10. So it will be 96,000. 96,657 pounds. So regarding part A, the company will lose this amount. Losing that amount, so debit minus. In this case, 10% of 10% discount allowed, 93,437.5 will round it to the nearest. So let's say 93,437.5 will make it as 438. Again, the company will lose that amount, so we'll give that within brackets. So if you consider the customer's suggestion, these are the amounts that they are going to lose with these two products, that is discount allowed. But they gain on the unused machine time. They can claim £60 on unused machine time. So this is that claim on unused machine time. Unused machine time. So that will be credit. The company gains that one. So gain, claim on unused machine time. There are two machine times, machine S and machine T. Now regarding part A, machine S time, no unused machine S time, because it's a limiting factor for product A, for part A, machine S time is the limiting factor. So when that is the limiting factor, it is fully utilized. So therefore, here, no gain, no machine S time, unutilized machine S time. So therefore, it's dash. Only machine T time. So how many hours of machine T time utilized? Look at that machine T time available, 4,500. 4,500 divided by each unit of part A requires 0.5. 0.5 hours. So that means each unit requires 0.5 hours. And how many units? Sorry. 4,500 hours minus this that available utilized 0.5 into 6,666 units. And that into this into unused machine time, they can claim £60. So that into 60. So look at that machine time utilized 0.5 into 666. That is 3,333 hours. Available 4,500. So unutilized 1,167 hours. That into £60 for every hour. So that is 70,020. There's the gain. So in this case, the company will lose, that they will, how much they will lose, it's 96,657 minus 70,020. So company will lose 26,637. The gain or loss? Gain, or will indicate the loss within brackets. So regarding part A, they can't consider the customer's suggestion because the company will lose this amount. But regarding part B, we'll see that discount allowed 93,438. Claim on unused machine time, machine S time, available 4,000 hours. So 4,000 minus, each unit of part B requires 0.25. 0.25 into 8125. It will require 2031.25 minus available 4,000. Unused machine time 1968.75 into 60 pounds. So it will be 118.125. How did I get that figure? It's 4,000 hours available, machine S time, but the company utilizes only, it's 0.25 hours per machine S time. So 0.25 into 8125 units of part B. So 0.5 into 8125. That into 60 pounds. So it's 0.5 into 8125 minus 0.5 into 0.25, not 0.5, I'm sorry, 0.25. 0.25 into 8125 minus 4,000 into 60 pounds. 118125. Similarly, machine T time, each unit requires 0.55. 0.55 into 8125. Required 4,468.75. Available 4,500. So the extra time, unutilized time, 31.25 into 60 pounds. 1875. 1875. So in this case, you compare that whatever the company loses and then the company gains. In this case, the company gains 118125 plus 1875. So 120,000 gain, but losing only 93,438. That means the company will gain 562. So with the customer's suggestion, we can observe that part B is better, some gain. But then we'll have to see whether this is all right with this one. So that is, you are getting a gain of 26,562. So we have to see, if we consider part B, whether this is all right with this one, whether if you take that together is better than this one. So if you take the customer's suggestion, there will be an increase in contribution, 26,562. So with that, it will be, so this is 162,500 plus 26,562. It will be 189,062. So there that the gain. So if you take that gain into account, the total contribution would be 189,000, which is better than this one, 179,000. So almost 10,000 more. So the question is, in this case, whether we can consider the customer's suggestion. Yes, you can consider, because that will improve the contribution by 10,000. So company will be happy to accept that suggestion. But in that case, they can't stick to the same product. They'll have to supply part B. Okay, they have to supply part B, because part A, with part A, they will lose that amount. So that will reduce the contribution. But with part B, they will gain. The reason that part B, in the case of part B, they gain, because you can see none of the machine time is a limiting factor. So you get unused machine time in both cases. Whereas here, one of the machine times is a limiting factor, for which you don't get any payment on unused machine time. So that is the reason this is not profitable with the customer's suggestion. That product A is not profitable because of that limiting factor. One of the machine times is a limiting factor. Okay. So answer to part C, they want to know, discuss whether your recommendation in part A above will be altered. Yes, it will be altered. In part A, we recommended product A. But now that alteration, that there will be a change in that one. And if so, calculate the new contribution. So the new contribution would be 189,062. Okay. So this is the contribution. Contribution. Taking the customer's suggestion into account. Suggestion into account. So you will accept the customer's suggestion into account.